scientist. I need your help. I'm making a friend for Mia, but I want the robot to look like a real person. And I'm not sure what I need to add to make it more human-like. What parts make up my body? Can you help me figure it out so we can finish this robot? Great, let's go. Let's start by taking a closer look at the human head. Take a moment to observe this head. What body parts do you see? Whenever you're ready, pause the video and label these parts in your guided notes. At the very top of the head is where people often have hair. Hair comes in lots of different colors, textures, and lengths, but not every person has hair. Some people wear wigs, and some wear hats to help protect their heads from the sun. I'm going to add some hair to my robot. I think Mia will like that. We know all about the eyes from when we learned about our senses. What do they help us do? That's right, see. Not everybody is able to see everything using their eyes. Some people use glasses or contacts to help them see. Some people need different ways to help them navigate the world, like using a special cane or a guide dog to help them get around. I'm going to give this robot eyes that use glasses. Yeah! What other body parts on the head help us with our senses? Yeah! The ears help us. Hear. Not all people can hear using their ears. Some people use hearing aids to enhance their sense of hearing. Others cannot hear at all and communicate using sign language. Cool. These ears are looking good. What other body parts do we need on this head? The nose helps us smell, and the mouth helps us taste. The mouth is cool because it's made of a few different parts: the lips, the teeth, and the tongue. But which one gives us that sense of taste? The tongue. Lips help open and close the mouth, and teeth do the chewing. This robot is looking great so far. The neck is an important body part for a few different reasons. First, it helps your head move up and down, back and forth, side to side, and even around. Slowly move your head around and appreciate all your neck can do. The neck also connects the head to the next part of the body, the torso. The torso is this whole section right here, made up of the chest, abdomen, and even the back. The chest moves in and out as you breathe through your nose or mouth. Take a deep breath, and I bet you'll notice it moving. Below the chest is the abdomen, where your belly button is located. Sometimes you might hear sounds coming from your abdomen if you're feeling hungry. The chest and the abdomen protect a lot of body parts that are on the inside of the body. Turn around and you'll find your back. The back is what helps keep your body upright and helps support the whole body. The torso connects not just to your head, but to all parts of your body. The arms are connected to your torso by the shoulder. The shoulder allows the whole arm to move. Try keeping your arm stiff and only moving around using your shoulder. It probably feels funny keeping it stiff like that, huh? That's because arms also have something called an elbow that allows the arm to bend in the middle. If you're able to, touch the top of your head. Can you do this? That's thanks to the help of your elbow. If you couldn't bend your arm in the middle, it would be super hard to reach up there. At the end of the arm is the hand. We learned about hands when we learned about the five senses. What sense does it represent? That's right, touch. We often use our hands to feel sensations from the world around us. Hands are especially useful when holding things, thanks to your fingers, which are able to move and grip. Arms and hands help us do so many things. We use them to pick things up, hold objects, and even to help us get from place to place. This robot is going to do so many cool things with these. Just like the shoulders do for the arms, hips create the connection between the torso and the leg and help you twist, bend, move side to side, and move forward and backward. Have you ever hula hooped before? Whew! Think of the workout your hips are getting during that. Humans use legs for so many different reasons. Legs help us to stand, walk, run, and even sit. The knee is what allows the leg to bend in the middle, and it would be really hard for us to move without it. At the bottom of the leg is the foot. Feet hold up our entire body weight whenever we stand, and they are used to keep the body balanced. When thinking about arms and legs, it's important to remember that even though they help people do lots of everyday activities, not all people have all of these body parts or can move them in the same ways. Some people use tools, like a wheelchair, to help them perform certain activities. Others may use prosthetics. Prosthetics are man-made body parts, like the ones I'm using to build Mia's friend, that replace the body parts a person does not have. Everybody has their own unique ways to explore the world around them. I can't wait for Mia to explore with her new friend. This robot is almost done, and wow, we looked at the human body from head to toe. We learned about a lot of parts on the head, torso, arms, and legs. But there's one more super important part we haven't learned about yet. I'll give you a hint. Every person has it, and it's something that's all over this robot because it's all over the human body. Make a prediction about what I'm talking about. Good guess. I'm talking about skin. Skin covers the entire body, and it keeps dirt and germs from getting inside our bodies, which could make us sick. Whether it's dark, light, or somewhere in between, skin is an important part of the human body, and an important part of this robot now, too. Ta-da! I'm naming this robot Sam. I hope Mia likes him. So, the next time you move around, try to think about what your body parts are doing for you. I know I will as I bring this robot to Mia. Remember, science is all around you, and it's part of you too. Hey, hey.